I'd like to commend Mr. Belford for having the courage, because as he was prepping to us all prior to this, he does not represent Zulu, nor can he speak on their behalf. So in a way, it's a bit pointless to have this conversation without the Zulu organization being able to speak for themselves. But with that, I hope that you have, as a Zulu member, my brother, able to go back to the organization and hear from your own community that there is a bit of a outcry to maybe adjust the images that's coming from the folks that people are able to see. So my suggestion, as someone here, would be that we take that Zulu warrior image that you guys embraced and go back to a warrior paint. Because as black people, we are still fighting. We're still fighting for access. We're still fighting for economic opportunity. We're still fighting for equality on so many fronts that fight still continues. So we're still fighting. We're still fighters. We're still warriors for so many causes that we as a black community continue to struggle with.
Thank you. Thank you.
Nola, take them down. My question is, can you still take this same vigor that you're taking over this issue? Because for me personally, as a black man, the word nigger that we still embrace, which confuses me, which is nationwide, not worldwide maybe even, not just in New Orleans, not just at Mardi Gras time, that's a bigger issue for us. That's a bigger issue for me. I DJ and I struggle to find music that doesn't use the word nigger.
And you used it twice.
Yeah, I used it twice. Emphatically, because again, that's much more demeaning to us. If you understand how vehemently that word was used to describe us and against us, can you have just as much vigor to take on that as you are with this conversation? Thank you.
Okay. That's a good question. For taking down Nola, but can we get over this idea that if we do one thing, we're missing another? They're not doing that.
Well, no. But my question is,
I get you. Yeah. I just want to say that is immaterial to the question at hand. We can do everything. We've done everything. We're right now juggling Trump, juggling Black Lives Matter, juggling this, juggling your issue. We should be on the Ed Sullivan Show if it was still on. But the point of the matter is, that's not an argument, a cogent argument to say that we shouldn't be doing this, or this is more important, everything's important. So can we just march away from that and just do everything we can on all fronts?
Thank you, sir. Now, like I said before, you don't have to go home, but you have to get out of here in just a few minutes. But I do want to say this, that I think the most important thing, one of the most important things about tonight, is that we had dialogue, nothing can be changed until it's faced. You may not change everything that you face, but nothing can be changed until it's faced. And so I think it's important that we start these conversations, and it's really important that you acknowledge that WBOK, the Louisiana Weekly, the New Orleans Tribune, Data News Weekly, and Think 504 are the people behind this event tonight. The black media put this on. It's important that that's this knowledge. One other thing I want to say, Brother Sekou was talking about E76, so he made me think about this. Mr. Andy Washington, I don't know if he's still here. He's 99 years old and 3 months. Aww. There he is right there. And so I want to thank everybody for coming out tonight. I think this was a great event. I'm proud to have been a part of it, and I think we all got along further along tonight. So thank you all for coming, and have a good night and safe ride home.
Okay.